This video accompanies the discussion of methods for examining numerical data in open intro statistics. In particular, we will learn about scatter plots for paired data, dot plots and the mean, histograms and shape, variance and standard deviation, and box plots, the median, and robust statistics. A scatter plot provides a case-by-case view of data for two numerical variables. Scatter plots are especially helpful for quickly spotting associations relating variables. A dot plot is a one-variable scatter plot. The mean, sometimes called the average, is a common way to measure the center of a distribution of data. Rather than showing the value of each observation, we might prefer to think of the values as belonging to a bin. For example, in the email 50 dataset, we create a table of counts for the number of cases with character counts between 0 and 5,000, then the number of cases between 5,000 and 10,000, and so on. These binned counts are plotted as bars in a figure called a histogram. Histograms are especially convenient for describing the shape of the data distribution. When data trail off to the right in this way, or have a long right tail, the shape is said to be right skewed. Data sets with the reverse characteristic, a long, thin tail to the left, are said to be left skewed. Data sets that show roughly equal trailing in both directions are called symmetric. A mode is represented by a prominent peak in the distribution. The histograms below have 1, 2, or 3 prominent peaks respectively. Such distributions are called unimodal, bimodal, and multimodal. Here, we introduce two measures of variability, the variance and the standard deviation. The variance is roughly the average squared distance from the mean. On the other hand, the standard deviation is the square root of the variance, and it roughly describes how far away the typical observation is from the mean. A box plot summarizes a data set using sample statistics and extreme values. These values include the median, aka the 50th percentile, or Q2, the interquartile range, which is the difference between Q3 and Q1, the 75th and 25th percentiles, and whiskers. For example, to calculate the upper whisker, we take Q3 plus 1.5 times the interquartile range, and then move towards the median until we reach the value of the nearest observation. You'll notice that some observations appear as specific dots beyond the whiskers. These are outliers, which are relative extreme values. In this video, we learned about methods for examining numerical data, including visualization techniques and numerical summaries. If you learned something you found interesting, share this video with a friend, and visit openintro.org for more resources.